Hi, welcome back to Keep It Simple. Today I'm going to show you how I saved £5,000 by accident. And then I'm going to show you how I saved at least £12,000 on top of that by accident. And we're now saving a few quid every day by the fact that the two accidents happened. So stay tuned, find out. Back in 2016, this was happening at our house. We had an extension put on it, which was very nice. Double story extension, end result is it looks like that, which is very good. And this is what we've got in our bedroom, and we've got one downstairs in the gym stroke living room, and it's used now. It was originally a split air conditioner. This is what our house view looks like. This is why it was worth doing stuff for, but this is a bit makies. This is what it would look like in the summer. It's rather a nice view, and that's why we stay here. Anyway, back to the story. We had a problem. We had nice radiators fitted and our heating system upgraded to work with the gas on the new extension, which was fine. It cost us a lot of money in radiators. But then 3 months after that, the system failed and we couldn't get it fixed. The reason being, it's too old. The house was built in 1983 and so the system was considered too old by everybody to be fixed. It's only a cheap valve, but I can't do it myself and nobody else will do it for us. So we had to use for the winter, because that was the summer time it was fitted, the air conditioning on the heat setting. And because of the way the thing works, this was one of the best decisions we ever made. At the end of the winter, our gas and electric bill was about the same as before the winter, as in we didn't have any extra bills for using the electric heating from the air conditioning. And so we carried on using it and didn't bother buying our new gas boiler, which we had quoted at over £5,000. Then a couple of years passed and the government are saying, get yourself air source heat pumps and the gas boilers will be discontinued. But they're not that efficient. But never mind, just go with it. And it's going to cost you about £12,000. £12,000 plus fitting. So anything between £12,000 and £15,000 to have yourself a replacement for your gas boiler. Well, that's not going to work for us. Okay, they are more efficient, possibly, but they don't even do the cooling. What we've got is, as was pointed out by Technology Connections, what we've got is a cooling and heating system, which does both jobs very well. And the efficiency on our system is this. We put 1.2 kilowatts in, we get 3 kilowatts out. That's why, when we took away the gas and used the electric, the bills remained roughly the same. And now, in the current climate, where everything is being made more expensive because of the wars and whatever, we're actually in the position where our gas bill would have doubled and our electric bill has only gone up by 50%. But because we're using electric, we haven't been that badly hit, but it has got serious. Our bills has gone from £180 to near enough £280, and it would have been a lot worse if we'd had gas. So that's how to do it. It's worth having a look at. I'm not trying to sell them, just letting you know it's worth looking at. But don't think you've got to go for the expensive £12,000 things. What we're using, quite simply, is a reversible air conditioner, and we're using an immersion for hot water, and it's saving us a lot of money. When we had these fitted, they cost £350 each, and the fitting was about £800. They've gone up a bit since then, but not a great deal, so it's well worth looking at. Anyway, just some information. Just a different way of looking at it, and let's keep the planet safe, keep the life simple. Cheers. If you've got anything out of this video, please pop a like, and maybe you'd like to subscribe. Thank you. Bye-bye.